fairy tale is a short story filled with enchantments that is a classic and familiar, often nursery standard. Cinderella, Red Riding Hood, Sleeping Beauty. Two, fairy tale is a generic narrative term for a certain kind of enchanted story that takes you to another world, a secondary world, as Tolkien called it. For example, Midsummer Night's Dream by Shakespeare is a fairy tale play. Three, one of the characteristics of both a fairy tale and the fairy tale genre is that it often imagines a previous teller. The story that you are hearing now is a variation on something in the past. Four, fairy tales are written in a shared language of symbols and images. We know we're in fairy tale territory when there is blood falling on the snow, or a red apple that might be poisoned, or bones that sing, or enchanted castles. There's a repertory of picture motifs. Five, the fairy tale can enter very dark places. Mothers die at the beginning of fairy tales. Stepmothers are cruel. Siblings can fight. Tyrants murder people. The parents abandon their children. These are very, very difficult areas that the fairy tale goes into. And it has made them a tool for many people to return to look at how we can cope with the tests that life presents us with. Six, fairy tales are not only mobile between cultures and across time, but between media. We mostly remember the first fairy tales we heard from the pictures. Seven, the media through which fairy tales travel and spread is not only in book form as illustrations in print and on the human voice, but above all through the performed media. So film has played an enormous role in the distribution of fairy tale. Disney's Snow White, 1937, is one of the most watched films in the world still. Eight, a dominant characteristic of fairy tale, it's almost too obvious to say, is enchantment and the supernatural. But the supernatural is there to help us hope, because another feature that's really important is that the end of the story holds out consolation, that whatever horrors have been described, they are going to come to an end. Nine. On the whole, even children know that this is a made-up world, where anything can happen because it's being invented, but it does not command the deep commitment of belief. 10. The heroes and heroines overcome their destinies, which are usually terrible. The ragged skivvy in the hearth is discovered to be a princess. The feckless boy who never does anything right and was booted out by his parents turns out to be the hero who kills the giant. There's a spirit of heroism in the humor of the tale. And very often a fairy tale will undercut itself at the very end. So for example, there's a conventional ending of a fairy tale, which is, well, they all lived happy and content while we sit here picking our teeth.